So every single year, there's a company who claims to have the lightest laptop in the world. Sometimes it's LG, sometimes it's ASUS, sometimes it's even Acer. In fact, the laptop I have right here is the Acer Swift 5, and right now, today, as of this video, it's the second lightest 14-inch laptop you can buy. Now, this is a big feat for these laptop companies, and my light is going bonanza. And I understand, it's a marketing perspective for them. It gets their name out there. But are they worth it? Like, who is this really for? Because some sacrifices are being made, but some advantages to it are also present. Now, in order to get these laptops this light, they have to use magnesium aluminum alloy instead of just aluminum alloy. Magnesium is 30% lighter than aluminum. Like, when you pick up the MacBook Air, this feels like a solid piece of metal. It's using aluminum alloy. When you pick up the Acer Swift 5, it's technically a metal, but it feels a lot like plastic. Now, you're getting a lighter laptop, like this one is like about 2 pounds, but when you touch it and you feel it, it just doesn't feel as premium as a MacBook Air. Now, a lot of these thin and light laptops are getting rid of the ports, but this one actually has a nice representation of the ports you'd use on a daily basis. On the left-hand side, you have your audio jack, you have a full-size HDMI port, you also have a USB 3.0 port, USB Type-C, which is not Thunderbolt 3. Then of course, on the other side, you have your Kensington lock, USB 2.0, and your headphone jack. Internally, not a lot is upgradable. Like, you have an M.2 drive that can be swapped out for something bigger and faster down the road. Same with Wi-Fi card if you want something that's a bit better, if there's a new feature that comes out and you want to put it in your laptop. RAM, completely soldered onto the motherboard. Like, there's nothing you can do about it. Whatever configuration you spec with, that's the RAM you're stuck with until you decide to get rid of this laptop. One fan, which is kind of disappointing for an i7, and I'll talk about that shortly, but what you do get is exceptional battery life. 54 watt hours, 9 hours and 20 minutes of use before needing to charge, and that's doing typical productivity with a little bit of idle time. This display is 14 inches, it's IPS, it's full HD, it is matte, so it handles reflections really well. It's also touch, which is not too common in most matte displays. The only thing I don't like is the fact that it's 16:9, which is fine if you're watching a lot of content on this, but I feel like this laptop really speaks out to like business executives, the person who travels a lot, the person who spends a lot of time writing documents or in document related work. Color accuracy is good, like it's good enough that you could do content creation on this. And gamut is also good. Brightness is average, like it's not gonna beat a MacBook Pro, but it's more than adequate for most situations. Webcam is on top and they managed to squeeze it in with very thin bezels. Unfortunately, just like every other laptop, it's not the greatest to use. So sound is coming out of these two speakers on the bottom of the laptop. They don't get loud at all, but they are clean and clear. You're better off using headphones if you want to get more sound hitting your eardrums. Performance is very interesting on this laptop. This is the latest i7th 10th gen processor, the 4-core version paired with the Iris Plus graphics chip. This is a graphics integrated graphics chip that has a lot more performance than the previous generation. On paper, this chip is just as powerful as the MX150. But unfortunately, this laptop is bottlenecking. The CPU is bottlenecking the GPU, and because of that, you're not getting the performance this thing can handle. They're doing this for one specific reason. Acer wants the user to have a very quiet experience. When this is under load, you can barely hear the fans. It also never gets hot, but it's thermal throttling the laptop to make this happen, which means clock speeds are always under base performance when all the cores are going. Now, this is fine if you're like the typical user who's just doing document work and browsing the internet, but if you're someone who needs to really push this laptop, you'll never see the true potential. This also means if you're looking at this, you might as well just buy the i5 version, because you're never gonna take advantage of the i7. Keyboard is not the best. There is a ton of keyboard flex, and these keys are really mushy. Not the best to type on, but it's not gonna affect your typing speed. I also don't like the fact that the page up and page down key are so close to the arrow keys. Touchpad is a good size. It's accurate. It is using Windows Precision Driver, but it's definitely not in my top 5 favorite touchpads. So circling back to the main question of this video, are these thin and light laptops worth it? And I absolutely think they are. If you're someone who's trying to push these things to its maximum potential, this is not the laptop for you. This is for someone who's on the road constantly, in and out of conferences, having meetings, and needs something that's really, really light. On top of that, they need a laptop that just doesn't get loud. Could you imagine going into a meeting or a conference call and your fans are kicking on and making all this noise? So that's why Acer has decided to reduce the amount of performance you get out of it to make sure you still have a quiet experience. Battery life is there, you still have enough ports, the USB Type-C can be used as a display mechanism, so it has all the potential that like a business persona would use. It's not for everybody, but I still think these light laptops have a place in the world, and I also think it pushes the market to really differentiate itself compared to like the thick, chunky laptops we're used to seeing. Anyways, that wraps up this review of the Acer Swift 5. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Like the video if you liked it, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in the next video.